Book lovers, welcome back to my channel. Today is going to be another big book haul, mainly because I forgot to do one for May. So I'm going to have two parts to this book haul. Part one today is going to be May books, and then tomorrow, hopefully I'll have it by tomorrow, my June book haul video is going to be up, my part two. If you saw my book haul for April, you probably could tell that I've been buying a bunch of historical romances, used historical romances, and I absolutely did not stop buying them after April ended. I bought about 50 back in April. I haven't done a count of how many I bought in May. Probably gonna be a similar amount, so you're gonna get a giant book haul of historical romances, as well as a sprinkling of some other stuff. But historical romances are all that I care about these days, and I just want to buy all these pretty covers. So I'm excited to show you guys what I got. Definitely more Lisa Kleypas, some Julie Garwood, and a bunch of other old school historical romance authors. Let me know if you've read any of them, because I loved hearing you guys talk about these old school romance authors that you read growing up or even today. Back in my last haul video, those comments were great. Love them. But first, I'm gonna do a little unboxing. I mean, not technically an unboxing because I already opened these boxes. I'm a rep for Hello Lovely Box, which is a romance box subscription. Although you don't have to subscribe to get all these goodies, you can use my code LACY15 if you want to buy anything. But here are all the good stuff that I got from them, from Becca, who is the owner of Hello Lovely. This video is not sponsored by them, as much as I would love some sponsors. So I'm a mug person. I love bookish mugs, and I have two of them from Hello Lovely. This one was sent, this one I ended up buying myself. It says reading is fundamental. It's this super pretty rose gold color. I love it. I'm actually using it right now for some lemonade. And then this one says read books, be kind, stay weird. And it's got this rubber bottom thing so it doesn't clang around on the table. I got some clothes too. They have such awesome t-shirts and sweaters and tank tops. So this one is the pizza t-shirt that came in the May surprise box. They have a monthly surprise box and it's a different theme every month. And last month for June it was Jane Austen. The month before it was pizza related, I think. But this t-shirt says pizza is my favorite love triangle. I got this tank top that says I'm all booked up. This super pretty sweater in this really nice light purple color. It says a well-read woman is a dangerous thing. It's a sweater, a hoodie, whatever you want to call it. This t-shirt that says support your local book babe. And last of the t-shirts is this stay inside read books pocket tee. I love them. I wear them every time I go out, which is not that often. And then in this big old box that I got, this one is June's surprise box. This mini backpack that says obstinate headstrong girl. There's always one big item in the surprise box, this backpack, that pizza t-shirt, and it also comes with two ebooks and a couple smaller items. I also got this giant pouch that has my name on it and also says be kind on the back. These two special edition books are in the summer bloom boxes. Candy Steiner's though I think is sold out already. This one is the alternate cover to A Love Letter to Whiskey. I haven't read this one yet, although people tell me it's very angsty, but I'm a little scared to read it. A friend told me that I might get a little angry and frustrated if I try to read it, so I've been holding off. And this one is Dear Mr. Black by Shanora Williams. This one I actually have read a long, long time ago. It's an age gap forbidden romance where she falls for her best friend's dad. And then these are the different kind of ebooks that you get in these boxes. Here's a cute whiskey pouch that goes along with A Love Letter to Whiskey. A pin that says keep calm and rom-com on, which was so hard to say, and a cute little mini candle. So that's my little unboxing for Hello Lovely. If you love romance books, if you love paperbacks with alternate editions, alternate covers, they have such fantastic ones. I really wish they would come back with some of the old ones that I missed out on. They have an alternate edition of Priest by Sierra Simone, Longshot by Kennedy Ryan, there's a Daphne Perry book, Sarah and I, a bunch of older ones that are sadly no longer available, but maybe someday. So let's move on to the books that I got. Most of these used books were from eBay, but I did find a couple good ones off of Amazon, the used book section. I don't know how many times I would message or send an email to a seller to double check it was like the cover or the edition that I wanted, because you gotta be careful about that stuff if you order like these used books with cover stock photos. Sometimes you don't get what they're advertising. So the first author that I want to show you guys is, of course, Joanna Lindsay. I got a bunch of these. Actually, most of these were from Jessica, Peaceful Books. She had a bunch of these extra copies, so she gave them to me. We kind of swapped the extras that we had. So this one is Keeper of the Heart with this step back. I think this was the one that I had without a step back, so I wanted it. A Pirate's Love, which has a pirate hero. Hearts of Flame, the original cover, the book that we all read for historical romance readathon, and I love. This one is all about Vikings and the heroine becomes the hero's captive. And Brave the Wild Wind, which I believe is one of her like Western romances. It takes place in Wyoming, and this one has the original cover. And this last Joanna Lindsay book that I got is Love Only Once with the original cover. This one I got from Instagram. Her handle is Romantically Swept Away Sarah. She's great. She is such a historical romance fan, and she sent this to me. It's got such a pretty cover, and I think this one is book one of the Mallory series. I only got a couple Joanna Lindsay books back in May, mainly because I got most of them in April, but I got a bunch of Lisa Kleypas books again, although this one is not Lisa Kleypas, it's Stephanie Lorenz, Viscount Breckenridge to the Rescue. This one is actually like an extra free copy that a seller on eBay sent with my order, which was super nice. I've been wanting to read Stephanie Lorenz. I have Devil's Bride that I still need to get to. And this historical romance series is a spin-off of the series that Devil's Bride is in. And these were the two books that came with the extra Stephanie Lorenz book. This one is When Strangers Marry with the step back. I own the one without the step back, so I wanted this. And I actually ended up getting the original. When Strangers Marry is a reprint and a retitle of Only in Your Arms. Lisa Kleypas also edited some stuff in the actual story for When Strangers Marry, but these are essentially the same book, just different titles and different covers. And then the sequel, the original cover of Only With Your Love. The series is actually set in New Orleans, one of her few that are set in America. And then I got this beautiful original cover of Because You're Mine with the step back, and it's in absolutely perfect condition. I'm amazed. This one is part of her Capitol Theater series about actor, actress, main characters. And then one of my amazing Amazon finds, this one, it was only $15. Usually these old school covers from Lisa Kleypas go up to $50, $100, but I found this really, really cheap, and it's in really, really good condition. It's Give Me Tonight. It's in Texas, one of her earliest books. This was back before she even published with Avon. This was with Berkeley. Another old school Berkeley book, Love Come to Me, but without a rip on the face that I originally got in my other copy. This one is also so pretty. You can see these side to side. They are so pretty. I wish they reprinted them again. I got Dreamy of You, only one of my favorites from Lisa Kleypas. This one has a step back, which I've been looking for like crazy. It's Derek and Sarah's book, and I love them so much. I got a couple of the Wallflowers with step backs. This one is It Happened When Autumn, book two. And then book three, Devil in Winter with this step back with a cape. I've read and love these. The Wallflower series is so good, and Devil in Winter was the very first Lisa Kleypas book that I ever read. Worth any price. This one I originally got, it was the library copy, so I had to donate it, but I got this with the step back. Prince of Dreams, which was also from my Instagram friend, with the step back. So, so pretty. I love her step backs so much. I have not read these two yet. And then the last step back that I bought for myself is Someone to Watch Over Me, and pretty much every hero in these step backs are absolutely ripped. I have read this one. I loved it. I think I gave it 4 stars. It's like the amnesia trope, which is so well done here. Next, I got some Julie Garwood books, who I have been loving ever since I read The Secret. That book blew me away, so now I'm trying to collect all of her books. She's basically my new Lisa Kleypas and Joanna Lindsay. I got these two editions of the Laird's Fiancée series, The Bride Bride and The Wedding. These covers are really simple, classic, and clean. I really like them. The Bride is the only one that I've read so far, but I don't really remember much that happened, so I'm gonna need to do a reread and then get to The Wedding. I have this alternate cover of The Bride as well. I have The Secret, which I loved so, so much. It was charming, it was funny, it was adorable. It was amazing. If you love strong heroines, you definitely need to read this one. I also have book two, the sequel, Ransom. This one actually has two romances and a lot of intrigue. These two pretty covers of Castles and Honor Splendor. I haven't read these two yet, but Honor Splendor, like the other books that I mentioned, it's medieval Scottish English romance, and Castles is actually one of her Regency romances. I don't know why, for some reason, I thought she only wrote medieval romances, but no, this one is set in the late 1800s, your typical historical romance era. I also got Gentle Warrior, which is another one of her medieval romances, and one of her novellas, her Western novellas, One Red Rose. There are three novellas in this Claiborne series, and this one is the last one. Those were all of my Julie Garwoods. This one is from Christina Dodd, and one of her very rare covers because it's the three-armed maiden cover, Castles in the Air, and the reason why it's messed up, is that the illustrator gave this heroine three arms. I don't know if you can see through the screen, but she has three hands, one on the ground, one holding the hero, and one by her side. It actually took me a while to find this one. I emailed so many bookstores for photos, but I finally found it. Have I read it? No. Will I ever read it? I don't know, but I'm just happy to have it. I also got a couple Kathleen E. Woodowis books, who is an OG historical romance author. I think she was publishing back in the 60s, if not earlier. So she was definitely one of the pioneers of historical romance. And I got A Rose in Winter, which has a really, really nice cover. This one is The Elusive Flame. I also have The Reluctant Suitor, and it's humongous. It's actually 580 pages. And last, this one is the oldest one, The Wolf and the Dove. This one published in 1974, I think. And it also has this really pretty red sprayed edges. I don't know if it came like this during printing, but it's great. All of her books are actually so long, and the font is the tiniest thing. I've also heard that there are some problematic things in her stories, which I'm not really surprised with since they're published so, so long ago. I also found, I was looking so hard for this one of my all-time favorite historical romances, Lord of Scoundrels. This one is the original cover. I already owned this reprint, but I had to find myself the original. This one, I love this book so, so much. It's kind of sort of enemies to lovers, but the banter is top tier. I love it, and Jessica is one of the best heroines I've ever read. I have the biggest girl crush on her. She is brilliant. I finally have some more modern historical romances that were published like within the last decade. The Virgin and the Rogue by Sophie Jordan, which is her latest release, and I really enjoyed this one. Okay, this one isn't quite that recent, but it's one of the Bridgerton's books by Julia Quinn, When He Was Wicked. This one is the original one with the step back. I mean, he's wearing a cape, she's wearing this gorgeous pink dress. Love it. This one, I believe, is book six in the Bridgertons and is Francesca's story. Lenora Bell, If I Only Had a Duke, the last book in the Disgraceful Duke series that I needed, but I think it's book two in the series. And I also got Lord of Darkness by Elizabeth Hoyt with a fake step back, which I'm so annoyed with. This one is part of her Maiden Lane series. I've been slowly collecting all of them. I'm almost there. These are paranormal, not historical, but Cressley Cole, of course, I had to get her. Anytime I get the chance to get her, I'll take them. These are part of her Immortals After Dark series. This one is Wicked Deeds on a Winter's Night. This one has a werewolf, a Highlander werewolf hero, and a witch heroine. Pleasure of a Dark Prince, which has another of the Highlander werewolves, the prince of them, and one of the Valkyrie heroines. And this third one one that I have is Dark Desires After Dusk with a demon hero and a half-human heroine. I've read all three of these. I've read the first 10 books in the Mortals After Dark series. I love it. It's one of my favorite paranormal romance series. If you haven't read her yet, Cressley Cole is fantastic. And I have one last stack of historical romances. This one is Dangerous to Love by Elizabeth Thornton. I've never read her before. I feel like I've heard of her, like seen her name, but look at the step back. The guy is quite hairy, but strangely it's just on his arm because his chest does not have any hair. Kimberly Cates, who I've also not read, never even heard of her. This one is The Raider's Bride, Touch of the Sun by Cynthia Wright, which is pretty old. It was published in 1978. Almost Heaven by Judith McNaught. I still need to read her. I'm so behind, but I know a lot of people love her. I have two Linda Lale Miller books. I've only ever seen this author whenever I go to Barnes & Noble. I see her name and then I see her Western cowboy romances. I've never read her before. I don't think I ever will. This one is My Darling Melissa and this one is Angel Fire. These two, they were published in 1989 and 1990. They actually have pretty nice covers. I wish it was the whole book instead of just this top half, but they look pretty nice. I really love this one for Angel Fire, especially because the full one, I don't know if you can see, but his hand on her thigh, quite possessive. This one is called Dark Before the Rising Sun by Laurie McBain, and it was published in 1982. Here's the back. And last of these used books is Queen Nora Roberts. These two are part of the Language of Love series that Silhouette published. So they all have covers like these. This one is Mind Over Matter. And this other one is Treasures Lost, Treasures Found. So I guess they're kind of like Harlequins because they're both really short and they're part of this one line. And finally, I do have some non-mass market paperbacks that I want to show you guys. Love Wrecked by Karina Halley. This one is her Shipwrecked on a Deserted Island romance, and I really like this one. I give it 4 stars. Surprisingly, it was really funny and really cute. I love the banter. It was great. Another one that I actually have read in this haul, The Billionaire's Fake Fiancé by Annika Martin. This one is the latest book in her Billionaire series, and I also really enjoyed. It was the only book that I have read in the series, and now I need to go back and catch myself up. This one is a fake relationship with the boss on a yacht kind of romance. I also got the first book in the series from Annika Martin. This one I won in a giveaway. This first book in the series is called The Billionaire's Wake Up Call Girl. And yes, this heroine is hired for the hero to wake him up at 4:30 every morning. But it turns out that he doesn't know it, but she's also one of his lowly assistants. I got Fallen Crest Camp Out by Tijen, one of her Fallen Crest books. It's really tiny. I have not finished the series. I'm not sure I ever will. I've only read the first 3 books and I read them years ago. I also got these 2 London prep books by Gillian Dodd. This heroine is an exchange student in London. I also got Love on Beach Avenue by Jennifer Probst. This one, the heroine is in the wedding business. I got this finished copy of the Happy Ever After playlist. This one without the whole messed up pages that I got originally. For some reason, the first finished copy that I got, the acknowledgments were all ripped up. But I love this book. I read it in my spring romances rom-coms video, and it's got the most adoring hero ever. The Girl Next Door by Chelsea M. Cameron, which is an FF romance set in a small town. I got Pike by T.M. Frazier. I also won this one in a giveaway. It's another one of her dark romances. I haven't read her in a while, but I have enjoyed the few books that I've read from her. I also got myself the first three books in Sarah Nye's How to Date a Douchebag series, but these are the pastel editions that you can only get at signings that she's at. But of course, a PolyCon got canceled this year, so she opened up like an online order form and I got these. These three are my favorites. Book one is The Studying Hours. Book two, probably my favorite, or at least tied with my favorite, The Failing Hours. And book three, the other favorites, The Learning Hours. I just love these pastel colors so, so much. I also got these 2 books from Mary Catherine Gebhard. I don't know how to pronounce her last name. This is actually books 2 and 3, which follow the same couple. This is actually books 2 and 3 in the series, following one couple. Book 2 is The Soulmate. Book 3 is Forbidden Fate. And I don't know if you can tell, but one of them is glossy. and one of them is Matt, which is kind of weird. Not sure what happened during printing. Jock Blocked by Pippa Grant, which is a sports romance, baseball romance. The box that this book came in also came with this little mug or tumbler, whatever you want to call it, and this baseball that I basically just let my dog play with. I got these two books thanks to Sourcebooks, The Tourist Attraction by Sarah and Morgan Thaler. This one is set in the snowy mountains with a grumpy hero, which I will always zero in on if I see it in a blurb. And Conventionally Yours by Annabeth Albert, which is an MM romance. It's got a road trip, enemies to lovers, Comic-Con kind of stuff. It sounds really cute. And last, I'm ending this book haul with Lisa Kleypas. This one is the hardcover of Smooth Talking Stranger, which is the third book in her Travis's series, and it's actually the correct size that I needed to match with my other hardcovers. The first copy that I got of this hardcover, for some reason, it was like smaller than this, so it bothered me that it didn't match the other hardcovers. But this one is the right size, and since I've already read the first two books, I need to read this one soon. So that's it for part one of this big old book haul. These are all the books that I got in May, so prepare for even more historical romances in June. Again, let me know if you've read any of these books, any of these authors. I'll link everything in the description below. Thank you so much for watching, and I'll see y'all next time. Bye!